he has to open up in his withers more. Yes, it's not about his pole being lower. It's not about collecting more. It's really in the center as well. Half holding and then lifting, as if your legs want to lift his withers up through the use of his hind legs. So every transition like that, so that you open up the top line, he doesn't sink down right in front of the saddle, and he stays up here. Good. If you feel that one of his inhales or shoulder four, then by all means use it. But keep your expectations for how he contacts himself on the end. Like we are half hold already. See, that's when he drifts out the shoulder. Good. That's what I would do. Just sort of negotiate that a little bit. The both hind legs work evenly. Right. Making a transition again before he is talking, you want to carry him in. But when I'm cantering a horse like that, I go, oh, this feels good, but nah. Then I make a transition. I don't want to go into that struggle of having to work harder, keeping him cantering because he leans on the hand or he doesn't react to the leg. Good for you. Yeah. Yeah, I like that. Even sort of the suggestion with your hand is, look, don't dive down. And stay up like we are, up through the wheel. Slow the canter down with your seat, but ride the hind leg a little bit at the same time. Okay? Your seat just don't run, but now your legs just come on through and then trail. And repeat that every few jumps like that. If you need to ride forward, because you feel you need to, then go ahead. But then when you are forward, let him know that he learns to react to your seat. Rather than reacting to the hands, just so. Exactly, it doesn't help. Right, right. Exactly. But having to help him, that's why. Help the hind leg, the hind leg helps him. Good, good. Okay. And those transitions, I will do a ton of those transitions. Because they make the horse understand that it's his responsibility to carry himself exactly. And you're not willing to let him go back to the trot when he is a bit fussy like that. No, not quite yet. Right. It's simple where the rider can say, okay, I like what I feel now, I go to the next thing. If you don't like what you're feeling right there, then you say, you can change things if you want to change that. But I, in his case, I don't want him to change his walk just because he can have a not such a good quality trot or whatever it is. So just holding that standard up to him. Yeah. And then also there, your outside rein helps him a little bit to get the basic straightness through his body, that when he's in a curved line, he's not drifting through the right shoulder there. Still a little bit, that's better. Much better. Really good. Okay. Especially then when I get to see him from the front, I can see a much more clear line through his body. Let that small half foot on the right rein. Yeah. Let your legs settle on his side. Good job, Brian. That every time he goes to the walk, your leg, even if he feels a bit lazy sometimes, it's not bumping. It's all like moving him laterally back and forth. Very useful, Brian. I keep testing the ability to ride a down transition, either in trot or into the walk, without using your rein ace more, just so that he starts learning to react to your seat, still accepting your leg. What you saw there in the mirror, did you look?
Yeah.
I like that outline.
Yeah.
But to me it looks good, if it feels good. Yeah, like that again. Yeah, it looks a little bit weak on his body, but nevertheless, it looks good where you're not carrying him. Excellent. That's it. Yep. And again, testing, is there a possibility to walk? If you don't walk, that's okay. But is that ability there from your seat without taking more connection in the bit? Right, and then are you able to ride on again, either into the walk? Good for you. and release. The release is really the finish of that half fall without the hind leg stirring. Yes. Good job. And as we...
Hi. Is Dad or Elson? I saw Elson just drive out.
He went to get food.
He went to get food.
Yeah. And I haven't seen Jeanette today. You need a, maybe that guy over there, he can tell you what, you need
okay.
A place. Yeah.
I just would love to be a place for him.
Yeah, I'm watching that right shoulder. Huh? That, he's a little, yes, good. Good for you. I like when I'm not allowed to finish a sentence on the side. when I watch somebody, it's like, all of a sudden people make me shut up because you're quicker than I am. Good for you. But once he starts to drift the shoulder out, you know he's not going to do his part with a hind leg. Yeah, good, Brian. Exactly. Do that again, starting from the center line this time, but only go no more than halfway sideways, so no further than the quarter line. And once you get there, start thinking about going back again. Just take your time.
Right.
Just take your time, get him set up. Right. So what I would do there, good, to the right vein there. What I would do, see how he wants to dive down?
Yeah.
I want to say something new and then I still talk about the old stuff. Oh, he is, isn't he? You want to do something new about the old stuff, it's finished yet. Good. Yeah. Make sure before you go back to the right, that your right leg is back, before you add your left leg going sideways. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like don't just push them sideways and then go, oh, I should have had my outside leg there. Right. And then start, exactly. And especially when you go back, when you go straight, but don't let them go yet to, yes. Supple on the right and then, yes. Much harder that way, but again, we're raising the standard to, is he on your outside ace, or is he just running away from your inside leg? Exactly. Good.
Oh, I like that.
And if necessary, do what we just did here. Walk, or something very basic again, until he is clearly understanding what you're looking for. Right. Yes. Very good idea. Just keep... Yes, keep letting him know there is a outside rein, but it's not holding me. Easy. Take all the time you need. Get him set. Right. Aha. Well, it's harder than it sounds, especially in that direction, because that's the side where he appears to me when I look at him. He seems to want to lean on the right rein. Yeah. Good. And then before you go back to the other side, walk real. That's where I would walk and say, okay, I'm not kidding. Yeah. There's another thing that you can...
Hey, Walter, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
That's right. The right leg is a little bit coming up there. Aha. Good. Good. That's it. Exactly. That's what I was talking about. Outer leg is here. Inside leg says, come on up here. Right. Let's see. So he has to wait there, right? That's why he runs away from using his body. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Good, fine, very good. It's not very many steps, but boy, it's something that he will learn, or can learn, to do without using. Let's go on a big circle to the right and do kind of what we did here. At the top, a little bit for the floor, or let you, and then walk. Just do it a few times. So he figures out, oh, he doesn't really have to use his neck to make the transition. Right. That's okay. That's okay. Good for you. You didn't hold him, and at the same time you provided him with enough contact where it helps him to stay round. Yep. Okay. Done. And before there's a problem, already another transition. So we make the transition before that we prevent problems. Good. Now sometimes we want to get the right trot, but it's hard for the horse. And do the walk before the problem is there. So then you're getting some good trot steps there. Then the transition before it gets stiffer, right? Exactly. Yeah. Right. Exactly, good. Good, fine. Let's take another break.
Yeah.
Boy, that right hind leg looked like spaghetti now. So we'll have probably another couple of minutes. Yeah, good. I like that connection. See, again, I'm looking at the frame of where the neck is. If you look at it in the mirror, it's much, much lower. It's much harder for him to work from the hind leg. In no way would I say raise the neck up, but you have to be early enough there with your next aid that he doesn't drop down, which is exactly what he has a hard time with. So just, you know, give him some time. Right, be diligent at this little haunch. It's a little tiny bit chubby. I'm thinking no more than a degree or two. Right, so that outside hind leg does its job in carrying. Good. Good, and that gives you a chance to be playful with your outside rein, so he doesn't lean on the right rein because he's a bit more responsive to your right leg. Yeah. Transition again, just like that. I like that. That's it. That's it. He's not running. Yeah, good. But in your mind, you have to think you're riding constantly over cavaletti, right? A little bit more of that lofty lifting kind of a trot instead of that charging kind of a trot. Right. Carefully a light feel a little bit, like more of a kicker than a trot, you know? Yeah. Somehow for the when you bring the tempo back, Brian, when you go from your lengthening to working, right, and you're working for your hover, that's when you touch him with the whip. The moment you're releasing on the rein. That's where you want to do it, because you don't want to do it when you're taking and then you get stuck. Same thing in the corner. You want a half hold, you use the whip or use your leg. You do it when you're able to release a little. So that in that release, there, the hind leg has room to go forward under the body. Right. And then already the next half, but I couldn't speak fast enough to tell you how often. Right. And you feel that. When the hip goes forward and your hand is light, that's when you can bring that hind leg under. Yeah, good, good. And that's where the transition should be. In that feel. Yeah, okay. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
Right? Because that's the feel where he's actually taking the weight on the hind leg, and we can make the transition without coming backwards from the rail by sitting actually. Yeah. Really do sit, like not against him, but through him, all the way through each stride. Yeah, good. And transition here. Why? Yeah, that's okay. That's okay. Don't have too much in front. Just play with it. No, walk is not a nose dive. It's a walk, it's an upward or forward transition to the walk. Right, good for you. It's really good, Brian, what you do with him. Being picky in a nice way, huh?